If you're a subscriber, sure do appreciate it. If not, consider doing so. And be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Okay, I'm in the A-liner today, and what I'm going to do is show you how to swap out the converter that changes the 120 to 12 volts. The symptoms that I was experiencing with the old converter, the one I'm about to take out, was when I had it hooked up to shore power or 120 volts, every time that I would cut on the circuit that had the lights inside this A-liner, the lights would go dim and the alarm would go off. It'd just be a steady beep, beep, beep with the alarm. So I went on Amazon and I found a converter. And the converter was $100. That included shipping here, and it should be a direct replacement for this converter. This is a 2006 A-liner Expedition, which puts it at about 9 years old. And the converter, we bought the unit used, or the A-liner used, and the converter had already been replaced once under warranty. And after doing some research, I did find out that the converter that came with the A-liners in that series, I believe the original converter is called an Elixir or Elex or something. I don't have the name in front of me right now. But I'm replacing it what's supposed to be a direct replacement made by a different company. So let's go ahead and get started with the install. This, by the way, is the brand of the converter that's in there. And I'm not real sure that this company is in business any longer. I think they had quite a few quality issues along the way. Now this is looking down into the area where the converter is, and I'm looking in from the top. As you can see towards the back where that bright spot is, that is where the shore power or the 110 comes in. Now I've taken the cord out to give me some room back there. And as you can see, it's just wire nuts that are involved. So I'm going to go ahead and start taking the old converter out. At this point, there's four screws that are holding the box to the front plate. There's a screw here, one over here, a couple down there. There may be four or five screws that are doing that. And then I'm going to take and pull the box forward. Now, I don't have the other box in here. It's not arrived yet. But as I understand, I'm going to need to transfer the fuses and the circuit breakers over to the other box. Now when you get down here taking these wires apart, if yours is like mine, some of these wire nuts you do not have to take off, and some you will. Some are just connecting the different circuits of the camper together, and others are actually going into the A-liner. For example, these two right here, these big yellow Romexes, where they're all connected here together, they're just connecting the circuits here. They actually come over on this side right here, go into the converter right over on this side here. Now I've got it out, and by the way, you can't see that, but the model number is an ELX20, which means this is a 20 amp converter. The one that's going to be going back is a 25 amp converter. You can always go up, but you can't go down. And by the way, it goes without saying, when you say that, you have to say it. Don't do this if you've not cut the power off. Please don't have it hooked up to your shore power during this time. You have to have totally all your power off. The other side of me says if I have to say that, then this is probably a job that you should not be doing if you have not already thought about cutting the power off. Well, now it's 3 days later and I have received the converter. I went ahead and took it out of the box, and as you can see, let me get it in the frame here, it comes with no circuit breakers. You just transfer the circuit breaker from the old box, and neither does it come with the fuses, the little automotive spade type fuses that are there. I did go ahead and check, and the wiring is the same on this one, or the wiring pattern is the same on this one as it was on the one I took back. White is the neutral, red is your positive, and then you have a yellow, green, and a blue. And what they will be are for the three individual DC circuits. Now, one thing that is kind of surprising on this model, and this is the model is a WFCO, and it's I don't know if that's WFCO, how you pronounce that or what, but it's a model WF875P. And the 875P, the 25, is designating the amp capacity of what this is, which is actually a maximum of 30 amp, 20 amp breaker that I'll put in here. So you have a 5 amp reserve. The thing that's a little puzzling that the instructions did not say anything about was, and that is, how do you route the AC wire? If you can take a look at the back of this, there is no outlet for the AC or the input for the AC. So what I'm going to need to do is knock out these two punch panels right here and go in and fish the AC cords out. I'll do that in just a moment. Okay, what you're looking at is actually the front. There's a panel that goes on here, and I just took the panel off, and this is how you get to the AC wires right here. Something's kind of concerning here. This wire right here is just a junction wire that goes together, but if you notice, there's no insulation on the end of that, so I'm glad I took this thing apart and took a look at it. I'm going to probably assume that this piece right here is a live wire. I'm going to go ahead and zoom in on that just a little bit and show you what I'm talking about. This piece right here, now that's where these two wires come together and they junction off. I'm not real sure why that's in there like that, but it's really strange. That looks like a piece of aluminum that may have been tying these two together. So I'm going to go ahead and take some black tape or a wire nut, and probably just some black tape, and put over that. Or I might even go in and get my heat shrink gun and put some heat shrink on there. But I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go in the house and put heat shrink on there, and then I'll come back and finish the complete install. Well, you can't tell much about it, but that's how far I've gotten today. The back of it over here, I'll try to get back in there so you can see a little bit, maybe down on this side right here. That's where your shore power comes in. That's the black. And then you've got your two yellow. That's your 110 circuits that are going out of the converter. Of course, there's no conversion being done here. It's just going to come in as 110 here and come out as 110 on this side right here. And that's what all of this junction box is right in here. And it's pretty crowded in there to work. Matter of fact, it's very crowded to work. There's going to be two circuit breakers that will be down in here. They're just removed from the other box and put in here. And as I said, once you get down here, that's where the fuses are. So now I've got these two circuits here. That's the two hot wires that are coming in. And then I've got to hook up the shore power, which is the neutral and the ground and the hot to this one right over through here. As hot as it is, though, I may wait till tomorrow to make sure that that's going on. Okay, not much to show. That's the progress looking down from the top. All the wires, I've tried to get the wire ties in there. It was a rat's nest when I started, and it's a rat's nest when I finished it. Here's the front panel right here. I did have to I did have to cut the bottom out just a little bit right down here. But that's the panel. Now all I gotta do is just screw it in. Well, it's installed. I did have to modify the little cutout down here for the circuit breakers. It was a little bit too small. But other than that, it fits in there okay. And then right here in the back, again, it's all mounted up. Pretty rat nesty. Now the next thing to do is plug it up and make sure everything is working okay. Well, I got the power supply in, already got everything boxed up, lids on it just right. Turn around, check it, and see if it works. And we've got light. Guys, don't be afraid to change out your power supply or your RV converter. Again, it takes about 3 or 4 hours to get through and do it. Get a shade to do it. It's pretty hot and kind of tight down through there, but nothing that requires a great deal of skill or effort. Until next time, be sure to subscribe. Give the video a thumbs up from the east side of Texas. This is John. See you on the next video.